To the bare skin.
That's fine, we'll come to it. Hey there, this is Samuel from Sense High, and today I'm here with the beautiful Nedra. And if you watched my video last week, which is the Black Mask, if you haven't watched it, make sure you watch it now. The links are below this video. I did mention that I'll do the Nedra series, and for those of you that watch and follow the channel, I've usually reviewed a lot of male perfume oils and perfumery types. And of course, there's a whole variety and a whole range of feminine perfume oils and perfumery types. And when I met Nedra, you know, she was like the perfect partner, and she was into perfume oils, perfumery types as well. And then, and so we have the opportunity to go through. so we have the. So I'm very excited because now we get to go through all the feminine, the female perfume oils and perfumery types that I have a scent hack. You know, some of you don't even know that we have. I have female perfume oils and perfumery types. You know, so I'm so excited. I'm so pumped. When I met Nedra, you know, I realized that she would be perfect because I cannot wear the female perfumes. You know, I had somebody actually ask me, you know, but I feel like, you know, the chemistry and everything, you know, it'd be perfect to have somebody, you know, like her, you know. And basically she will get like the perfect female review or like hair take and different things like that, you know. So I'm very excited to have her and to go through it now. So today what we have here, we have Prada Candy, and you know, you used it. How long did you like generally use it for?
I've used this all week. Plus today. Happy Easter.
So Prada, I don't know if I have anything from Prada, but do you own any Prada products or?
I do not.
That's you guys. I mean, I think most women have something from Prada, maybe. That's like.
I do have something Prada, but I don't know what it is.
Oh, see, it's kind of like hard to believe, but.
I have one thing Prada, but what is it?
So okay, I don't think I have anything from Prada, you know. But Prada is an expensive, like, I feel like a top designer.
It could be. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know they have several perfumes. I don't really buy Prada, but I think I might after trying this.
Mm. Oh, they are perfumes. So this Prada Candy, the perfume oil type, was actually inspired from the Prada candy. So there's a perfume. So when you smell it, what was the first things that you picked up from it? I mean,
let me smell it again.
Okay.
So with the Prada candy, the first thing I smell is like the fresh scent. I don't know if, and most of the females may know, but the scent that you smell when you smell cotton blossom from Bath and Body Works, that's what I get initially. So when I smell it initially, it's like that cotton blossom, cherry blossom smell, and it also has like a citrus scent to it. So it's almost like a citrus blossom if I had to rename the perfume.
Wow.
Like a citrus blossom. That's what I would name this. It's really pretty. It's really light. I like to wear it heavy. So I like to wear a lot of it, because throughout the day, the scent becomes more floral than citrus. So if you put just a little bit on, you would smell, for some reason, more of that citrus scent. But when you put it on heavy, you smell more of the floral scent. So again, like I said, if you are a person that shops at like Bath and Body Works or Victoria's Secret, if you've ever gone to Victoria's Secret during like the semi-annual sale and you've gotten Midnight Mimosa, or you've gotten that those discontinued scents like the Cherry Blossom and the Cotton Blossom, that's similar to the scent of this with a little bit more citrus scent in it. So again, if I had to rename this Prada candy perfume, I would name it Citrus Blossom because that's the combination it reminds me of.
Oh wow, that's very interesting. Yeah, because even the name, and that's some good insights, because even just by looking at the name, I always, because with the candy, I always thought it was going to be sweet, you know, yeah, like candy, gum, or kind of sweet.
It's sweet, but it's not too sweet. It's not like your Love Spell sweet or your Pure Seduction sweet. Hmm. And those are your Victoria's Secret scents that actually smell like candy, actually smell like sugar. It gives you that real powerful, like Kool-Aid almost type of smell. This isn't like that. This is a lot more subtle than that powerful, sugary, Kool-Aid candy type of smell. This is a lot more subtle. It's giving a lot more floral scent. I don't know if you've ever smelled like Gucci floral. It's a lot more subtle than that powerful kitty smell is what I call it.
Mm. Oh, wow. Wow. That's really amazing. Like, you know, I call, because I love citrus too, and I could see that's something that I would really enjoy, like smelling on, like smelling from, you know, from a woman or from a lady. That's amazing. So, you said you put a few dabs on you. In terms of the projection, like, was it something that, like, a few dabs, like, on you, like when you put it on, do you put it on your neck or you put it in between your...
So actually the way that I use Prada candy, and I use each oil differently and I put each oil in different places on the body. So with Prada candy, I actually put it on as soon as I get out of the shower. And the way that I apply Prada candy, which is why it's a lot missing, is I actually do about 4 strips on each arm. And that is because, as I explained before, throughout the day, you'll start to smell more of that floral scent. And this actually lasts all day if you apply it that way. So I apply it about 4 strips to the bare skin.
Mm-hmm. And that's fine. We'll come to
bare skin. And I actually take unscented lotion, or either unscented shea butter, and I rub it in with the shea butter or with the lotion. And then I rub the remaining on my legs. And that's how I like to apply Prada candy. It's very different from how I would apply like the Jamaican plum. Hint, hint, that's a suggestion for you ladies. I know it's unisex, but that's the perfect scent for a female who loves those floral, subtle scents. So, with the Jamaican plum, all I need is just a couple of dabs on the wrist, and I'm good to go for the rest of the day. But with the Prada candy, like I said, if you want that lasting floral scent throughout the day, you need to apply a little bit more in a larger area.
And I know she mentioned Jamaican plum, and that's something that I urge you guys to look out for, because we're both gonna do a review on Jamaican plum. I did a review on it before. That was when I just started the channel, and you know, and she used it, and she like gave me some new depth onto like certain things I missed on it, and I didn't realize how powerful it is, you know, until like she started to use it. And you know, when I smelled it on her, it was just amazing. But I will not, you know, spell it out all yet. You know, we're going to do a full review on Jamaican plum. So, look out for that. But if you want to see the review that I did before, I have the links below this video. So you can watch that one. And then look out for the next one that we do. And you get her version too as well. It's, you know, anyway, we'll come to that. With application, you have to, based on how she, you know, described him with her application and like the projection and how it smells, looks like it's not, it wouldn't totally be like staying so close to your skin. It looks like if people could smell it, you know, based on the proximity that they have with you. Does it, and you know, I know you said it, did it remind you of anything similar? I know you mentioned something before, but.
So, again, this scent, it puts me in the mind of, when I think of perfume, I'm thinking of more like the Heat by Beyonce. But as far as, I know most women buy like the body mist. So if you're thinking from a body mist perspective, this is more of like that, again, like the blossom scents that you can buy. But also, one perfume that, and I know Victoria's Secret also have one perfume that this reminds me of. It's not 100% there, but reminds me of, it puts me in the mind of Heavenly. So if you are one of those like Heavenly or Angel type of scent people, then you would really love Private Candy, because it's subtle, it's not too powerful, but it's also lasting. And I know that Heavenly is like that. It's very rich. It's lasting. It's something that everybody will notice immediately, but it's not too powerful. So you won't overtake the room, but everyone will smell you. Everyone will like that scent. I can't say 100% of people, but maybe 98% of the people will like this scent, male and female, once they smell it on you.
Would you think, like, people, in terms of the age group, you see, like, older people, like, maybe, I'd say, older, matured women, maybe rocking it better, or, like, maybe younger youth could pull it off here and there, or what would be the demographics?
So, with Prada Candy, if I compare it to, like, the Jamaican Plum, so the Jamaican Plum, I think anybody, any age could wear that. I mean, all the way from 18 up until 70 could rock the Jamaican Plum. Versus this Prada Candy, I see this being more of your mature crowd. So I would say maybe mature, but maybe someone much older wouldn't prefer this. So I would say that 25 to 45 age range may prefer Prada Candy. Elderly, absolutely not. This would be a little bit overbearing for them. But the Prada Candy is not an overbearing scent. But for someone older, this would be a little bit too young for them. But it's still a mature scent. So I would say between 25 and 45 would really like this scent. It's not saying that the other age groups would not like this scent, but that age group, I think, would prefer this scent.
The age group that, you know, you could get, you know, for your wife, your girlfriend, you know, your sister, or, you know, the ladies in your life, and, you know, I'm sure she'll love it, you know. I'm sure she'll love it. So, did you get any vanilla smell from it at all?
I wouldn't necessarily say vanilla, but there is, like, a maybe, like, a fig undertone.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, like the fig. I don't know if, like, ladies, you wear the brown sugar and fig. There is a little bit of that, or like the twilight wood, you know, that woody smell. I wouldn't necessarily say vanilla, but maybe like that woody scent or fig scent. You do get a little bit of that.
Okay. So did you, meanwhile, do you feel like you got any mask or any benzoin notes at all?
There may be a hint of musk, but I think that's more of the woody scent that I'm smelling. You know, I don't really do the musk, but I think if there is, it's just very faint. Very faint. It's not that much musk.
Okay, so there you have it, Prada Candy. Do you have any final thoughts?
My final thoughts on Prada Candy, like I said, if you like Heavenly or Angel, or any of those blossom scents, more than likely you would like Prada Candy. Apart from those scents being like your popular scents, this one is one that it's a little bit more powerful than those, but not overbearing. And it'll stand out. So Prada Candy is definitely one that stands out, but very subtle.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. So I'm not sure if I asked this before in the when we started talking, but so do you think, is there something you think you wear it to work, or something you could wear it to a date, or something?
So Prada Candy, I have worn Prada Candy all week, which means I have worn it to work, I have worn it to the store, I've worn it on a date, I've worn it to a social event. I've literally worn it every day this week. Well, last week, because today is Sunday. So I've worn it every day last week, plus today on Easter. And I think everywhere it's definitely appropriate everywhere.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. So there you have it, guys. You know, it's very, very versatile, you know, based on what I'm getting. It's very, very versatile. And, you know, I know we're just going into spring. Well, we're actually in spring now, you know, so.
Yeah, but it's snowing tomorrow.
We'll have this snow, that snow tomorrow. But hopefully that'll be it, you know. But who knows, you know. But I mean, it's getting to spring, you know, we'll be getting more active, you know. So this is like a good pick, you know, like I said, you know, for anybody that, you know, guys or, you know, girls, you could get this for yourself or for your, you know, your sisters or your moms. Guys, this is a great thing to get for your girlfriend or, you know, for the women in your life, you know. So, you know, that's it. If you want to get this Prada Candy, you can definitely get it from Centhack. It's only $5.99, and it includes free shipping. I'll personally ship it to you. Leave your comments below, and you know, answer it, or she'll answer it. Mostly she'll answer it, you know, because she, you know, reviewed it, and she'll have like a better, you know, feminine perspective of it. And if you miss anything at all, you know, from the video, I always do make a blog post of whatever I talked about, including like the notes that she picked up on and different things like that, you know. So make sure you go to the website, the link is below this video. Go to scentshack.com, you know, I leave a blog post, you could read on it and catch up on all the notes and everything as well. Once again, finally, if you're not subscribed, please make sure you subscribe. Subscription button is right here. And take care, happy Easter, and we will see you next time.